my students, at first I would like to welcome all of you to Bhanga Virtual School. I hope that all of you are well by the grace of Almighty Creator. I am also well by the grace of Almighty Creator. Dear students, I hope that you are staying at home, and by staying at home, you will attend the class from Bhanga Virtual School and you will take preparation and get you will take preparation and improve your skills. Okay. Now let's start. I am Jaydev Kumar Pal, assistant teacher, English, Bhanga Gop Pilot High School, Bhanga Faridpur. You can see the identification. Dear students, we are going to take class for class 7 subject English first paper, and time will be only 25 minutes. So class 7 subject English first paper, time 25 minutes. Okay, now let's start our class. Dear students, look at the photo. Okay, we will start our class by seeing a photo of a woman. Okay, you see, look at the photo. I hope that all of you know her because she is a famous person. Okay, there is a question for you. Have you ever seen the photo of the woman? Have you ever seen the photo of the woman? Can anyone tell the name of the woman? I hope that some of you or all of you will able to tell the name of the woman of the photo. Yes, you are right. She is Begum Rokeya. She is Begum Rokeya. You are right. So we are going to learn about Begum Rokeya, class 7 English first paper, unit 5, lesson 1, title Begum Rokeya. I hope that all of you are ready with your EFT English for today to go through the class. Okay, so please be attentive to class. Let's start our class. Learning outcomes. So there are some learning outcomes. I hope that after finishing the class, our students or you will be able to read and understand the text, understand the vocabulary, famous, undivided, landlord, cooperative, encourage. Ask and answer questions, transfer information, practice passive voice. So these are the learning outcomes of this class. I hope that after finishing the class, our students will be, or you will be able to develop your skills to the point. Dear students, we will start our class by some vocabulary. Vocabulary is very important. There we will find some key words. These key words will help you to understand the text very carefully, okay, very easily. And these words will be very helpful for you. So first word is famous. Undivided, landlord, cooperative, encourage, go on. Dear students, you have to just think about the meaning of the word and you have to guess the meaning of the word. Okay. So I would like to ask you, you have to just guess the meaning of the given word. I repeat, famous, undivided, landlord, cooperative, encourage, go on, and last one is communicative. You have to communicate. You have to think the meaning of the words. Okay. Now, dear students, we can analyze the meaning and the application of the words, vocabulary, word meaning. First word is famous. I hope all of you know the meaning of the famous. Famous means well known. A person when he or she becomes known to all of us by his doing good works, he becomes famous. Okay. So famous means well known, renowned, eminent. For example, Qazi Nazrul Islam is a famous poet. Okay. Next one. Undivided. Undivided means what? Undivided means united, joined, combined, not separated, together. Okay. So undivided means something which is not divided into any parts. Okay. This is combined, united, joined. Okay. These words means undivided. For example, he lives in an undivided family. He lives in an undivided family. That means he lives in a joint family. His family is not separated. Okay. Next one, landlord. This here we find two words, land and lord. So who is a landlord? What is the meaning of landlord? The meaning of landlord is an owner or a person who possesses a vast property. Okay. And in past, general people would pay the person money and crops as tax. Okay. The person is called landlord. Okay. For example, he was a great landlord. Okay. Next one, cooperative. Cooperative is very helpful. Very helpful. Mr. Rohim is very cooperative. Encourage. Encourage means motivate, to give courage, inspiration, motivation, others to do something good in society. So encourage. Encourage means motivate, to give someone motivation, inspiration, to do good things in the society. That is called encourage. Okay. For example, we should encourage others to do good things in the society. Please pay attention. We should encourage others to do good things in the society. Okay. Next one, go on. Go on means to continue your work. Okay. Go on means to continue something. For example, you can go on with your work. That means you can continue your work. Next one, communicate. Okay. Communicate. Communicate means to share or exchange information, news, ideas, etc. with others. So communicate means to share or to exchange some information, our news, our ideas, etc. with others in the society. For example, we can communicate easily over mobile phone with others. We can communicate with others very easily over mobile phone. So these are the keywords. These keywords will help you to understand your text very easily, very effectively. Okay. So dear students, now take your EFT. We will go to our next step. Dear students, now take your EFT, English for Today, page 45, and read the passages very carefully. I will help you to read the passage. I will try my level best to make you understand the passage very effectively. Okay. So please pay attention. Begum Rokeya. We have already known that our lesson is about Begum Rokeya. Begum Rokeya was a famous writer and a social worker. She lived in undivided Bengal in the early 20th century. She believed that women should have the same rights and opportunities as men have in the society. So she fought for their cause throughout her life. Begum Rokeya was born in a village called Pairaband, Rangpur in 1880. Her father, Johiruddin Muhammad Abu Ali Haidar Saber, was an educated landlord. Rokeya was married to Khan Bahadur Shakaut Hussain in 1896. Her husband was the deputy magistrate of Bhagalpur, now a district in the Indian state of Bihar. He was very cooperative and always encouraged Rokeya to go on with her activities. Many upper class Muslims of Bengal at that time learned Arabic and Persian as medium of education and communication. But Rokeya had great love for her mother tongue. She learned Bangla and English from her eldest brother Ibrahim. So this is the passage. Now I will explain the passage in my own words so that you can understand the passage very easily. Okay, please pay attention and be attentive. Begum Rokeya. was a famous writer. Begum Rukia was a famous writer and a social worker. Okay, she was not only a writer but also a social worker. You know, social worker, a person who works for the development of the society. So Begum Rukia was such a person. He was a writer and very famous, and also was a social worker. He worked for the welfare of the society. She lived in undivided Bengal in the early 20th century. She lived in undivided Bengal. That means at that time Bengal was not divided into three or four parts. Okay, this Bengal was united, combined. And when in the early 20th century, 20th century means 1900 plus. Okay, now she believed, she means Begum Rukia, believed that women should have the same rights and opportunities as men in the society. So Begum Rukia firmly believed that women are also part of the society. They have also same rights and opportunities as men have in the society. Okay, so she fought for their causes throughout her life. So she means Begum Rukia fought throughout her life to establish these rights and opportunities for the women in society. So she fought for their cause. Their cause means to establish their rights and opportunities as men enjoy in the society throughout her life. Okay, Begum Rukia was born in a village called Pairaban, Rangpur in 1880. So in the second paragraph we will see the personal information of Begum Rukia, and the first paragraph we have seen that there is the information of activities of Begum Rukia. Okay, Begum Rukia was born in a village called Pairaban, Rangpur in 1880. Okay, her father Jaluddin Muhammad Abu Ali Haider Saber was an educated landlord. Her father was not a poor man or an uneducated man. Her father was a rich man and he was a landlord. So we understand very easily that Begum Rukia came of a rich family and an educated family, because her father was an educated landlord. Okay. Rukia was married to Khan Bahadur Shakaut Hussain in 1896. So Begum Rukia was married to Khan Bahadur Shakaut Hussain in 1896. In 1896 means at the age of 16. At the age of 16, we can calculate it from her year of birth and from year of her marriage. So at the age of 18, in the year of 1896, that means at the age of 16, she was married to Khan Bahadur Shakaut Hussain. Her husband was the deputy magistrate of Bhagalpur, now a district in the Indian state of Bihar. Her husband was also an educated person. He was not an uneducated person. He was a deputy magistrate. Okay, deputy magistrate of Bhagalpur. Now this Bhagalpur is now in Indian state of Bihar. Bihar is also a district of Indian state. Her husband was very cooperative. That means he was very helpful and always encouraged Rukia. And her husband always encouraged Rukia. That means motivated Rukia, gave motivation, inspiration Rukia to go on. To go on means to continue with her activities. Her activities means her education, her social work, her writing. Okay, that is all for the second paragraph. Now the last paragraph. Many upper class Muslims of Bengal at that time learnt Arabic and Persian as medium of education. So at that time many upper class Muslims of Bengal at that time learnt two languages, that is Arabic and Persian, for the medium of education and communication. But Rukia had great love for her mother tongue. But Rukia had also a great love for her mother tongue. So besides these two languages, Begum Rukia learned Bangla and English from her eldest brother Ibrahim. Okay, so Begum Rukia learned Bangla and English from her eldest brother Ibrahim. That is about the passage. I have tried my level best to make you understand the passage very effectively, and I hope that all you have understood the passage very effectively. Okay. Now, dear students, we will go to our next step, classwork activities. The students now answer the following questions. I hope that all of you have understood the passage very effectively, and you are ready with your EFT and your text, copy and pen to give the answer of the following questions. This is our classroom activities or classwork. First question is, who was Begum Rokeya? Very simple question, who was Begum Rokeya? You will get the answer of the passage, and you have to write the answer of the passage with the help of your EFT. Who was Begum Rokeya? What was Begum Rokeya's belief? What was Begum Rokeya's belief? What did she fight for? Number four, why did many upper class Muslims learn Arabic and Persian at that time? Next one, why did Begum Rokeya learn Bangla and English? I hope that the scheme is very clear. We are just operating a multimedia class. Okay, so I hope that you can see the questions in the screen. First one is, who was Begum Rokeya? Dear students, you have to think at first and then write the answer of the following questions. Okay, who was Begum Rokeya? What was Begum Rokeya's belief? What did she fight for? Why did many upper class Muslims learn Arabic and Persian at that time? Why did Begum Rokeya learn Bangla and English? Okay, so just think about the answer of the questions. We will just discuss the answer of the questions in the next step. Okay, dear students, I hope that you have already thought about the answer of the questions. So, answer of the given questions. First one, the question was, who was Begum Rokeya? Begum Rokeya was a famous writer and a social worker of undivided Bengal in the early 20th century. So Begum Rokeya was a famous writer and a social worker of undivided Bengal in the early 20th century. Okay. Next one, Begum Rokeya's belief was that women should have the same rights and opportunities as men have in the society. The question was, what was Begum Rokeya's belief? Okay. The answer is, Begum Rokeya's belief was that women should have the same rights and opportunities as men have in the society. Next one, Begum Rokeya or she fought for their cause or rights and opportunities throughout her life. Begum Rokeya or she, you can also use both noun or pronoun, fought for their cause and rights and opportunities throughout her life. Number four, many upper class Muslims of Bengal at that time learnt Arabic and Persian as medium of education and communication. Okay, so many upper class Muslims of Bengal at that time learnt Arabic and Persian as medium of education and communication. The students, you will just follow in what type of tense, in what tense the questions are given. Okay, you have to follow the tense of the questions. If the question is in present tense, you will write the answer of the in the present tense. If the question is given in the past tense, you have to write the answer of the questions in the past tense. And you know, when we find any did in the questions, we omit the did and we make the main verb into present tense. Okay, the question was, why did many upper class Muslims of Bengal at that time learn? Okay, but answer will be, we have omitted what and did, and the answer is like that. Many upper class Muslims of Bengal at that time learned. This verb has turned into past tense. Okay, so when we omit did, we have to turn the main verb into past tense. Arabic and Persian as medium of education and communication. Okay. All the answer of the questions is the same. There was also the did, mention of did. We have omitted did and we have turned the verb into past tense. Okay. Just keep it in mind. Last one. Begum Rokeya had great love for her mother tongue, So she learned Bangla for her great love for mother tongue, English for education and communication. There was the questions, why did Begum Rokeya learn Bangla and English? So Begum Rokeya had a great love for her mother tongue Bangla, so she learned Bangla and English as a medium of education and communication. That is the answer of the questions. So I hope that to write the answer correctly, you have to follow the tense of the questions and also the correct information you are putting in your answer. Okay, so you have to follow the tense. The questions was given in past tense, so we have written the answer of the questions into past tense. Okay, so when there is the reference of any did, we omit the did and we turn the main verb into past tense. Okay, so you have to just keep in mind this point. Okay, and also you have to give the correct information from the passage into your answer, then you will get good marks. Okay, this is how the questions have to write. Next one, there is another classwork activities for you all. It is called information transfer information. Okay, complete the following chart with information from the text. Complete the following chart with information from the text. So you can see there is a table for you. There are some information and you have to write the answer of the information. Begum Rokeya, the clue is about occupation. You have to write the answer about her occupation. Born in, that's mean year. Married in, that's mean year. Family, the information about her family. Language, about information about language. Okay, so dear students, you do not need to draw the table in your answer script. Okay, you have to just write the answer like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or A, B, C, D. Okay, so many students I have seen that they try to write draw the table in your answer script. No, you do not need to draw any table. Okay, just you have to write the answer like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is how. So occupation, think about her occupation. Okay, the occupation of Begum Rokeya. Born in, that's mean year, when was she born. Okay, married in, when was she married. Family, the information about her family. Language, and information about language Begum Rokeya learned. So dear students, I will give you some time for thinking about the answer of the questions. I hope that you will think about the answer of the questions at your home. Now we will just go through the answer of the clue, information transfer. This is called information transfer. So you have to take the information from the passage and you have to put or write the correct information about the clue. Okay, so the answer of the first one is famous writer and social worker. Occupation, so the occupation of Begum Rokeya, she was a famous writer and a social worker. Okay, now born in 1880, married in 1896. Family, her family was educated, we have got the information through our passage. And language, she learnt Bangla and English. Okay, she learnt Bangla and English. That is, this is the answer, and you have to write the answer of this information transfer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this. Okay, you need not draw the table in your answer script. So I hope that you all of you have understood this point. Now we will go through our next step. This is also classwork parts. Grammar. Now we will just discuss for grammar. In grammatical item, we have to learn the structure of passive voice. Okay. So we know the voices. Voice are mainly two types: active voice and passive voice. Okay. So what is active voice? When subject does the work of the sentence, it is active voice. And when subject does not do the work of the sentence, it becomes passive voice. Okay, in passive voice, preference is given on subject. In passive voice, preference is given on subject in the place of sorry, preference is given on object in the place of subject. Okay, in passive voice, preference is given on object, not in the subject. Okay, so what is, for example, Begum Rokeya was encouraged by her husband. Begum Rokeya was encouraged by her husband. Begum Rokeya's subject was be verb, encouraged past participle form of main verb, by and the object her husband. Okay, Begum Rokeya was encouraged by her husband. Okay, now we will see the structure of the passive voice. Structure: subject, be verb, BPP, that's mean past participle of verb, you can also say V3, extension. In extension, there should be reference of by plus object. Okay, so subject, be verb, you know, am is are was or be been. If the sentence is present tense, you have to write am is are. If the sentence is past tense, you have to write was or. Okay, and VPP, past participle form of verb. This is the passive form of a sentence. Be verb and the past participle form of verb. Okay, you have, there is an exercise for you. Her husband encouraged Begum Rokeya. This is an example. Just think about the answer of the questions. Okay, I will help you. Begum Rokeya was encouraged by her husband. Begum Rokeya was object of active voice. We have made the subject of passive voice. So the object of passive voice, active voice becomes subject of passive voice. There is a reference of be verb was, because the sentence is in past tense, so we have given was as a be verb, encouraged, past participle of verb, encouraged by, and the subject of active voice has become the object of passive voice. So I repeat, the object of active voice becomes the subject of passive voice. Am is are or was are as be verb, past participle form of verb, in extension there is reference of by, and the subject of active voice become the object of passive voice. Okay, this is the a structure and example of this sentence. Dear students, now it is time to evaluation. Just tell the meaning of the words. Okay, famous, undivided, go on, cooperative, encourage, landlord. We have already discussed about the meaning and the example of these words. I hope that all of you have understood, that you will able to answer these questions to your guardian. Okay, this evaluation part, your guardian also help you to take the correct answer. Okay, I would like to request all of the guardians to take care of your child at home. Okay, tell the meanings of the words: famous, undivided, go on, cooperative, encourage, and landlord. I hope that all of you be able to give the answer of the questions. There are some questions for you. Who is Begum Rokeya? When was she born? There is a mistake. When was she born? Who encouraged her to continue her study? What is the structure of passive voice? This is the question. I just help you the answer. Who is Begum Rokeya? Begum Rokeya is a famous writer and a social worker. When was she born? She was born in 1880. Who encouraged her to continue her study? Her husband encouraged her to continue her study. You can also make the reference the name of her husband. Okay, and what is the structure of passive voice? Subject plus be verb plus VPP plus extension. In extension, there is by plus object. Okay, that is all for evaluation. I would like to request the guardians to take care of your child at home, so that they can give the answer it to you. Okay, other students, I would like to give you homework. Make 5 multiple choice questions. You have to just make 5 MCQ. If you understand the passage very effectively, I hope that you will be able to make effective 5 MCQ. Okay, 5 short MCQ, and make 5 new questions. We have discussed so many questions in our class, but I hope that you will also think very deeply and you will try to make more new questions. Okay, you know, clear writing comes from clear thinking. If your thinking is clear, I hope that you will be able to make 5 new questions. So this is about your homework. Okay, make 5 multiple choice questions and make 5 new questions. We are very ending part of our class. Dear students, I hope that all of you have enjoyed my multimedia class in Manga Virtual School, and I would like to request you to attend all the classes. Dear students, I would like to request you attend all classes from Manga Virtual School. This school or the class in this school will be very helpful for you to get your preparation, to develop your skills. Okay, we will try our level best to give the class continuously, and you will follow the class routine, and you, according to class routine, you will attend the class from Manga Virtual School. That was the all, that is all from today. So dear students, thank you very much. Thank you all of you, and I would like to request all the guardians to take care of your child at home so that they can continue their class and they can continue their homework. Okay, that is all. Thank you all.